Did you know your body makes its own THC? Your endocannabinoid system creates and uses chemicals similar to the THC and CBD found in cannabis. We are still learning about all the things this system does, but we do know it has a big impact on our memory, sleep, digestion, and other important functions. For young people and teenagers, it is important to know that adding external substances affects your developing brain and body. If someone does choose to use cannabis, remember each method affects you slightly differently. The method you choose influences the speed it takes effect, length of effects, and the amount of THC in your bloodstream at one time. Smoking hits quickly, lasts about 4 hours, and the THC in the blood doesn't spike as high as vapes or concentrates. Vaporization also hits quickly, with higher spikes of THC. Edibles, on the other hand, are slow to take effect, last much longer, and reaches full effect over time rather than all at once. For someone who uses cannabis, it is important to consider what these differences mean when deciding how to use responsibly. For example, because smoking takes effect quickly, it is important to go slow so you can notice if the effects are too strong. This allows you to slow down or stop if needed. However, like smoking any plant, it contains tar that might affect the lungs. Vaping might have less tar, but has other chemicals and high temperatures that can hurt the lungs. And high spikes of THC increase the risk of cannabis toxicity, uncomfortable sensations like paranoia or psychosis, another reason to go slow. And while edibles release their THC much slower, sometimes someone might try to take more, thinking it's not working, causing uncomfortable highs that can interfere with your commitments by feeling the effects longer than planned. Using too much of any cannabis product can cause these uncomfortable effects, sometimes called greenouts, and over time, frequent use can disrupt the development of our brains and bodies. Remember, even though not everyone that uses cannabis will develop a cannabis use disorder, there are ways to use more responsibly to decrease your risk. The best way to prevent future issues is to not use or to wait as long as possible before trying cannabis, while our brain fully develops at about 25 years old. You can also choose to use only licensed products, use in small quantities and lower strengths, and to use not very often. No matter what you decide about cannabis use, make sure to stay informed, stay safe, and be the best you can be.